I don't want to lose any strikers. Yeah, the only way I can see this working is to get rid of these centre mids. It's not ideal, but by the rate it's going, mate, you might be moving on to your centre backs anyway.
Stop taking the piss.
But yeah, that last one was very tight. I won it by one goal.
Yeah, crazy.
And we're playing a full American team here. Something different. One thing I'll say about Americans is they're crazy. Yeah. Americans are crazy. Seriously.
It wasn't one goal. It was one shot on target.
Okay. So basically, yeah, I mean, you have a look at this guy's team. You'd really expect to pick up results today. Now, I've got a big problem with this team, guys. I am struggling to score goals. I'm sure you've said this. Okay. Didn't you say?
I think we're both struggling a little bit.
We're both struggling
to score. These single-player matches are weird.
They are.
It's odd. Do you guys find that single-player matches play differently? Because we're finding, like, I don't know. It's just harder to score for some reason.
Mm.
FIFA excuses?
I don't know. To be honest, it could just be the fact we're in denial because we've lost a game or...
Maybe.
I don't know. But anyway, today we needed a win, guys. Big time. We needed to win this game. And he took a lead, which was incredible. I've never seen anything like it because I've never been so dominant. And he scored a header from absolutely nothing. And that just made me so mad that I went on to absolutely bum him 3-1.
Yeah, sometimes it
really... Big time.
Yeah, it really rattles you up.
It does. And it makes you play better sometimes. Not you. It makes you play worse. When he's losing, he always starts moaning and he takes his hand off the control.
Stop with the grief. You win 3-1.
We win 3-1 and we have 14 shots on target. You're going to need something. Look at this. Jesus.
I know it.
You're going to need something special to beat that. Let's have a look how Matt gets on.
Okay then, guys, 2 matches go, and yes, we did win, so that means that we don't have to put a bronze crap shite player into the team, although they're not really being that shite right now, are they? I mean, mine's certainly playing quite well, but I've only got one, so it's probably not impacting the team quite as much as you're impacting the team with your bronzes.
That is a very nice team, can I just say.
Yeah. And,
right, guys, I've got informed Tevez. I'd rather have Remy in my team.
Well,
I'm sure I'd rather have Remy in my team.
Yeah, that's actually an interesting point because I was talking about this with you guys on Twitter last night and how Aguero isn't really shining for me either. Now, what we are actually going to change some things around very soon with the formations because we figured out that, you know, these players, Tevez and Aguero, just do not fit in a 4-3-3. No. They're not that kind of player. They're not getting in there. They're meant to be potentially up front with a partner.
I mean, you look at Tevez's stats in form. Tevez. Yes. And you look at his stats and you think, Jesus, you know, he should be incredible. His stats are amazing. Yeah. He just seems to play like crap.
Imagine Tevez and Aguero together up front. Mm. Together. Now, that's an interesting... Anyway, okay, so do you think that we should change our formation for the last few games, you know, to try and get the best out of these players?
I think so.
Leave a comment right now and let us know about that. So this game, we did manage to get the breakthrough with the 1-0 goal there. And 90 minutes, this guy came so close to equalising, but he just didn't expect it to go to his play there. So we do win 1-0. So... let's get on to the next section and let's see who won this one.